I'm basically a vitrorectal surgeon. I'm from Narayana Nethralaya, Bangalore. So this is predominantly, I think, cataract specialty IC. But we do see a lot of patients who come with complications of PCR, and hence important that we know what to do and what not to do. Mine was supposed to be a concluding talk. Hence, I had just summarized what not to do, and if you are faced with something like that, you know how to go about it. But I think the other two speakers are not there, so I'm just going to go about and play my video.
Number 1. Do not let the anterior chamber collapse. The anterior chamber collapse leads to the vitreous prolapse through the dent, which leads to the enlargement of the PCR. The lens matter may also drop into the vitreous cavity. Do not withdraw the phaco probe on seeing a PCR. Keep the irrigation on, inject OVD under the nucleus fragment through the side port. Either withdraw the phaco probe out of the eye or complete the phaco emulsification under the cover of OVD. Number 2. Do not continue phaco emulsification in PCR. In PCR happening early during phaco emulsification, with most of the lens still present, do not continue phaco emulsification. Rather, convert to a manual small incision cataract surgery. Number 3. Do not fish in the vitreous cavity for nucleus fragments. This will cause traction on the vitreous base and cause giant retinal tear. Number 4. Do not let the PCR extend further. Convert PCR into continuous posterior capsular rectus whenever possible. Do not enlarge the PCR further with the cutter. The margins of the posterior capsule, the shape of the cutter, are not resistant to tearing as a posterior capsular rectus. Number 5. Always use bimanual anterior vitrectomy with the irrigation handpiece separated from the aspiration cutting handpiece. The irrigation in a coaxial cutter causes hydration of the vitreous with further prolapse and enlargement of the PCR. Number 6. The cutter should always be below the irrigation handpiece. Do not dip the irrigation handpiece below the cutting handpiece, as this will lead to hydration and anterior migration of the vitreous. Number 7. Do not forget to check for vitreous strand in the AC. This is done by injecting dilute preservative-free triamcinolone. Number 8. Do not use inappropriate parameters for vitrectomy. Ideal parameters include low vacuum, low aspiration flow rate, low bottom height, and highest cut rate available. Number 9. Do not implant single-piece foldable IOL in the ciliary sulcus. Single-piece foldable IOLs have a thick haptic optic junction, causing continuous erosion of the posterior pigment epithelium. Three-piece IOLs are better suited for this, and one can perform a good optic capture in the anterior rectus. So, to conclude, the ideal management of cases with posterior capsular vent is phacoemulsification with continuous viscose injection. Thank you.